guys, today I'm making black beans. I like my black beans to be very flavorful, so I'm adding some red onion, some coconut milk, green bell pepper, red bell pepper, some garlic and butter, scallions. So all of that is going in the pot. Then I also like to add some olive oil. You don't need to worry about chopping it even more because I'm going to blend everything. Most of the time I like it to have a little bit of beans, but my daughter doesn't like it like that. So I'm just going to puree everything, and I'm making it for her. So I want to do it the way she likes it. Then another trick that I do is adding some moringa. I have some dry moringa. I'm just going to add a little bit. And even the stem, because normally what I do, I use the leaves for tea, and then like the stem, this part here, I put it in my stew. Like if I'm making a sauce or black beans, I put it in there. So this is another way to make your black beans more nutritious. I'm just going to let this cook, and then before boiling the beans, I let them soak in water. You can let it soak overnight, but I just let it soak for about an hour or two, and then that way it helps to expedite the cooking process, because it tends to take a long time for the beans to soften up, because I like to use black beans, not just like things out of the can, you know, so real beans. So we're just going to let this cook. And another trick to expedite the cooking process is adding baking soda, like a pinch of baking soda. But I don't like to do that. I just prefer soaking it as long as I can, and then just let it cook, cover the pot with enough water, and put a little bit of oil, because I like to use good quality oil, olive oil. Extra virgin olive oil, because like for instance, if you forget the beans, you know, that way it's not gonna burn. So that's what the oil does. It helps it to prevent like the bottom part of the pot. Sometimes it take all the beans just sit there and they burn. So your bean come out tasting like, you know, like a burnt basically. So that's what I do. And I'm just gonna let this cook. Alright, so the beans are cooked. And what I like to do is use a fork to smash it to make sure that it, you know, you can use your fingers too, but when it's hot, you don't want to burn yourself. So you just use this, and you can see that it's well cooked. Because if it's not cooked well, the beans, the sauce is not gonna come out right. It's gonna come out gray, and then it won't taste good. So now I'm going to blend this. So I just blended this and pour it in this. So now I'm adding some of the beans, like from the sauce from the beans, to help strain the beans. Alright guys, the black beans is ready.
Mommy!
That's how I like it. I like my rice to be submerged in the beans. Now I have this beans on the side, then I can just add a few of them, because I love to have the idea of having little beans in my sauce bowl. But again, my daughter, she likes it to be like saucy, no beans. Very good.
Hey guys, enjoying some rice and beans. And some meat. I like my rice and beans to be wet. Like that.
This is falling off the bone.
Well cooked.